So, all right, so we're going to talk about something here. Moore's talk with Moore's. Holy shit, it's Moore's. Could you help with your crit arc build? Yes. Noxus, you are next. This will be very quickly. Quick discussion. Hopefully it's quick. All right. So there was a lot of discussion about the Ascendancy release. I did watch the podcast. There was a bunch of threads on Reddit. You know, people saying a lot of stuff. I think a lot of the points they were making, there was good points, there were bad points. I don't think anyone was making a fool out of themselves, right? I want to be very clear about that. But I do think some people who were saying things didn't have the full perspective on stuff just because they haven't played that long. Now, actually, I spent a long time trying to get the old tree so I could show it side by side. I have my huge poster of the, like, closed beta tree. Finding a picture of the closed beta tree was so tough. I couldn't believe how tough it was. With Moore's. Skunk Juice, thank you very much for 8 months. So, okay, people were talking about builds, right? Ziggy D was talking about... Ziggy D had a whole video, which you can find out there, talking about Ascendancy and all this stuff. But basically, what people were saying was that... And let me get this here. Get a brush. Get a size. So basically, people were talking about wherever you start on the tree. Like, you start here, right? And you do a bunch of stuff, and then you get a bunch of stuff, and then you get a bunch of stuff, and you end up here. Like, this is basically what people were saying all builds were like. Wherever you started, you would get this, you get a bunch of things here, and then you get a bunch of things here, and then that's your build, right? And so the thing is, what people don't realize is that this was an intentional change on GGG's part when they released Scion. Now, Chris came out and said there were people making builds that were playing Scion the whole time. Now, at one point, the middle of the tree looked more kind of like basically like this. Is that how I would describe it? The tree looked like this. It was this type of shape, really. So not quite like the Scion, but you had paths through the middle. So you could, you know, like I used to play a Wander build. I basically took Crip's build and said, I want to do a tanky Wander that does MF, because and maybe buffs too. Crip never wanted to do that. So I started Templar, right? And I came over here to get, I think I got EB, and like some, maybe some wand crit and some stuff like that. And then I went along this highway down here, and IR was like here before, right? Now this type of build that I just made, what people would call a Skilgrimage or Skildrasil build, you cannot do anymore unless you play Scion. So, of course, people are all like, well, it's so boring because everyone's playing Scion. Well, the problem is to link disparate parts of the tree together at this point, you must be playing a Scion to do that. So, for instance, if I wanted to make, let's just say EB's I hate the new EB, but I don't want to fight about it. But let's say I wanted to make an EB block build. Well, you're trying to link this, this, and this. How are you going to do that unless you start the class that can do this stuff, right? That's the only... This looks like a penis now, but the only way to do this type of build is to start Scion. You have to start in the middle because you're cutting through the middle, and the only way to do that is Scion. Now, yes, granted, you could start Marauder, you can come to Duelist, and you can go through this crap over here, but you end up in a really weird spot. It's really kind of terrible, especially this evasion wheel is really garbage. So it like cuts off so much of the tree. Now, of course, the life wheel is insane. Life wheel is great, but that's why we see a lot of builds that are basically, I do a bunch of stuff and then I come down here like that. Like so many builds just have this little bloop and they get all these nodes because there is a scarcity of life in the tree. And so the problem with builds, basically all builds being... So like if you were... Let's just take Marauder. Every Marauder build consists of basically three things. You're either Marauder and some Duelist and some Templar. You can be Marauder to like that, right? But that's still an arc. You could be... I'm trying to think of other builds I've seen. You can be Marauder, Duelist... And I guess maybe some ranger, sort of a tank block character. You could be, I don't know, Like, that's really, those are the, basically, or you could be really heavily Marauder Duelist, like a Cycloner. But everything's an arc starting from the thing. And like, if we did the math, whatever permutations of builds there are, it's so limited because you're always stuck with your neighbors, no matter what you're doing, right? So, but before, I used to make my Iron Will build, it started in Marauder, it came down here to Duelist, I then went like this, and then up like that. Look at this build. So this is like Shadow, Marauder, some Duelist, some Witch. This does not exist anymore. You cannot make a build like this. And, so when people are talking about Ascendancy classes, limiting being a limiting factor, the problem is the game, when they released Scion, they, in my opinion, kind of ruined a big part of cool builds, which were builds that went through the middle and did something weird. Now, you wasted points going through the middle, and you still do that kind of now. Scion is inefficient at certain points because you have sort of travel points. But if you can link some of these things, you get a really awesome effect, an outcome that's above and beyond the sum of the parts. And so, it kind of doesn't matter what they do at this point with Ascendancy. You're never going to recapture that because of the Scion in the middle. And, I mean, I personally think that there's going to be less choice. There's going to be less build diversity. There's just no way that three Ascendancy classes will cover all the permutations of builds that people can do with specific characters. They're forcing you into more... they're forcing you to play their game. And granted, it's a game that GGG designs, right? A game I love, and I think they do a really good job designing it. But at some point, they shifted the design focus from truly letting us do almost anything we wanted to. They're constricting us ever so slowly all the time into this thing. Now, is it still possible to do this type of build? Sure. The difference is the travel points have changed. There's so many more points. There's so many more things to do. And also, the other problem with the tree now, compared to what it used to be, there's so many of these things. See all these circles? Circle, circle. He's huge circles on the outside of the tree. I really don't like this. This is a new one right there, this Force Shaper one. I really don't like these wheels on the outside of the tree. It used to be they were more inside. And again, I tried to find my oldest build calculator, 1.0. The program won't load because, it's just so old it's broken, I guess. But anyway, that was sort of my talk about the tree and sort of the things that... people have a problem with it, and I understand why, because you can't make the builds that you want to make. So anyway, that's sort of my two cents. I think hopefully Ascendancy is a good, positive thing, but it won't be the same game that people have been playing since closed beta. Games change. It's probably too tough to balance where there's complete openness like it kind of used to be, so that's just how it is. I think from a business standpoint and growth, it makes sense to limit us slightly, like you say. It makes it easier for new players to get in the game. Especially asking on Reddit, what class should I make? Yeah, and that's fair. My response would be, PoE is not about that, and PoE throws you into the deep end, and just you got to sink or swim. That's kind of what PoE is about. But yes, that has less broad appeal. So I think that's just sort of the natural evolution. Maybe not natural is the wrong word. It's the evolution of the game that the people at GGG who are deciding these things, this is the direction they're taking. I don't agree. I don't like. I haven't, honestly, since basically the Scion was added, I have not liked the skill tree. I still make it work. I still really enjoy theorycrafting because there's a problem, right? But the overall direction of the tree, and I've talked about this before in previous videos, I haven't been... it's not like I'm not like gonna kill myself or something, like I'm not gonna like cry every day. It's just we had two paths, right? Our path diverged in the wood, and they're going left and I would have gone right, and that's all it comes down to. So okay.